कैंटो 9 चैप्टर 2 द डायनेस्टी ऑफ द सन्स ऑफ मनु. सो इन दिस एक्चुअली द प्रीवियस चैप्टर वाज अबाउट किंग सुद्युम्ना who actually born as the daughter of seventh Manu. Okay, so there the description was going on, and in the previous canto, that is canto 8, the all 8 Manus were explained. Sorry, 14 Manu. Previous, present, past, present, future, all the Manus explanation were there. And then in the 9th canto, Parikshit Maharaj inquired that he want to know about the dynasties of this 7th Manu, which is the present Manu, Vaivaswat Manu, and because he is the son of Vaivaswan, so his name becomes Vaivaswat Manu. Okay, his name was Radhadev. Okay, so this Manu was not having any son or daughter. He wanted to have a son because so that the dynasty can go on. And but he was not having son, so they did a yagya, and in yagya his wife gave the instruction that she wanted a daughter. So the ahuti was given accordingly, and the daughter was born. And then Manu asked, how come this is like daughter is born? So then Vasishtha prayed to Lord Vishnu, and Vishnu being pleased with the prayers of Vasishtha, he made this girl Ila, her name was Ila, made her as man, Sudyumna. Sudyumna, while traveling in for hunting, he entered in the Sukumara forest in Ilavrata Varsha, and there, because of the arrangement of Lord Shiva, he and all his associates became women, and there he met with the son of moon, Soma, the son of Soma, Somaputra. So his name was Buddha, and now Sudyumna became a woman, so she married with Buddha, and they had a child named Pururava. Okay, so like that, Pururava, once upon a time, Pururava was the ruler for both the dynasties, Sun dynasty and the Moon dynasty. So anyway, this arrangement happened, and then when they got to know about the situation of King Sudyumna, that he became a girl. And then again Vasishtha did worship to Lord Shiva, and Shiva being pleased with Vasishtha made arrangement that okay, 1 month he will be a girl and 1 month he will be a boy. So then he 1 month he was ruling as a king, and one month he will live inside as a daughter. So he was not very satisfied. Praja, the citizens also were not very satisfied. And then when the time came, King Sudyumna, he renounced everything and he went into the jungle. That was the summary till now. And then further in the chapter 2 we shall see. Okay, so I think we have discussed already. I have read the summary of chapter 2. If somebody can tell me whether it was read. Okay, it's not read. So this second chapter describes the dynasties of the sons of Manu, headed by Karusha. After Sudyumna accepted the order of Vanaprastha, and departed for the forest, Vaivaswat Manu, being desirous of sons, worshipped the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and consequently begot 10 sons like Maharaj Ikshvaku, all of whom were like their father. One of these sons, Prasiddhra, was engaged in the duty of protecting cow at night with a sword in his hand. Following the order of the spiritual master, he would stand in this way for the entire night. Once in the darkness of night, a tiger seized a cow from the cowshed, and when Prasiddhra came to know this, he took a sword in his hand and followed the tiger. Unfortunately, when he finally approached the tiger, he could not distinguish between the cow and the tiger in the dark, and thus he killed the cow. Because of this, his spiritual master cursed him to take birth in a Shudra family. But Prasiddhra practiced mystic yoga, and in bhakti yoga he worshipped the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then he voluntarily entered a blazing forest fire, thus relinquishing his material body and going back home, back to Godhead. This interesting story will come in this chapter. Kavi, the youngest son of Manu, was a great devotee of the Supreme Personality of Godhead from his very childhood. From Manu's son, known as Karush, a sect of Kshatriyas known as Karushas was generated. Manu also had a son known as Dhrishta, from whom another sect of Kshatriyas was generated, but although they were born of one who had the qualities of Kshatriya, they became Brahmanas. From Nirga, another son of Manu came, and the sons from Nirga, another son of Manu, this is third one, came the sons and grandsons known as Sumati, Bhutajyoti and Vasu. From Vasu in succession came Pratika, and from him came Bhogavan. Descending in order from the seminal dynasty of Narishyanta, another son of Manu were Chitrasena, Riksha, Midvan, Purna, Indrasena, Vitihotra, Satyashrava, Purushrava, Devadatta and Agnivesha. From the Kshatriya known as Agnivesha came the celebrated Brahman dynasty known as Agnivesyayana. From the seminal dynasty of Dhrishta, another son of Manu, came Nabhaga, and from him in succession came Bhalandana. Bhalandana, Vatsa Priti, Pramsu, Pramati, Khanitra, Chakshus, Vimsati, Ramba, Khaninetra, Karna, Dhamma, Avikship, Marutta, Dhamma, Rajyavardhan, Subdriti, Nara, Kevala, Dhunduman, Vegavan, Buddha and Trinabindu. In this way, many sons and grandsons were born in this dynasty. From Trinabindu came a daughter named Ilavila, from whom Kuvera took birth. Trinabindu also had three sons named Vishala, Sunyabandhu and Dhumraketu. The sons of Vishala was Hemchandra, his son was Dhumraksha, and his son was Sanyama. The sons of Sanyama were Devas and Krishashva. Krishashva's son was Somdatta, performed as Ashwamedha sacrifice, and by worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead Vishnu, he achieved the Supreme Perfection of going back home, back to Godhead. Okay, so it's mainly the thing is about the names here, whose son was who. Okay, so first 14th shloka will talk about the story of Prasidra, who was cursed by his guru. Later, still, even though he was cursed about by his guru, but still he attained the perfection. The next, from 16 to 22, the descendant of Karusha, Dhrishta and Narishyanta. So these are different sons of Vaivasvata Manu. Okay, so then next section of this chapter is 23rd to 36, that is the descendant of Dhrishta, another son of Manu. So Manu had 10 sons. So like that, this chapter ends here. Okay, so now we shall go with the one by one shloka. Sri Shuka Uvacha एवं गते यथा सुद्युम्ने मनुर्वैवस्वता सुते पुत्र कामस्तपस्ते पे यमुनायां शतं समा. ओके, श्री शुक उवाच. श्री सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेड एवं दस गते हैड एक्सेप्टेड द ऑर्डर ऑफ वन प्रस्ताता देयर आफ्टर सुद्युम्ने व्हेन सुद्युम्ना मनु Vaivasvata Manu, known as Shraddhadev Sute, his son Putra Kama, desired to get son Tapat, Epe, executed Siva Shri Yamunayam on the bank of the Yamuna, Satam Sama for 100 years. Sukhdev Goswami said, thereafter, when his son Sudyumna had thus gone to the forest to accept the order of Vanaprastha, Vaivasvata Manu, whose name is Shraddhadev, being desirous of getting more sons, performed severe austerities on the bank of the Yamuna for 100 years. Okay. Tato yajan manurdevam apatyartham harim prabhum ikshvaku purva rajan putran leve swasadrishandasha. Tata, thereafter, Ayajat worshipped Manu, Vaivasvata Manu, Devam, unto the Supreme Personality of Godhead, apatya artham with the desire to get sons harim and to hari the supreme personality of god at prabhum the lord ikshvaku purujan of whom the eldest was named ikshvaku putran sanslebe god swad sadrishan exactly like himself dasha 10 So then because of this desire for sons, the Manu known as Shraddhadev worshipped the Supreme Lord, the personality of Godhead, the Lord of the demigods. Thus he got 10 sons exactly like himself. Among them all, Ikshvaku was eldest. So this is Suryavansa. Okay. Suryavansa, and because Surya son is Vaivaswat, Shraddhadev, his son is Ikshvaku. So that's why this dynasty name also is Ikshvaku Vansa. Sometimes you may hear Ikshvaku Vansa. Bhagwan Sri Ramchandra appeared in this dynasty only. That's why in Ramayana you will see that Lord Ram is from Ikshvaku Vansa, because the king Ikshvaku was very famous. The dynasty is also known as Ikshvaku Vansa. But originally this is Suryavansa only. Okay. प्रसद्रस्तु मनोपुत्रो गोपालो गुरुणा कर्पितः पालयाम आशगा यत्तो रात्रायाम वीरासन वृता प्रसद्र तु among them प्रसद्रा मनो ऑफ मनु पुत्रा द सन गोपाला हर्डिंग कॉल गुरुणा बाय द ऑर्डर ऑफ हिज स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर कृता हैविंग बीन एंगेज पालयाम आशा ही प्रोटेक्टेड गा काउ यत्ता सो एंगेज रात्रायाम एट नाइट Virasana Vrataha, taking the vow of Virasan, standing with a sword. Among these sons, Prasidra, following the order of his spiritual master, was engaged as a protector of cows. Okay, he would stand all night with a sword to give the cows protection. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. One who becomes Virasan takes the vow to stand all night with a sword to give protection to the cows. Because Prasidra was engaged in this way, it is to be understood that he had no dynasty. We can further understand from this vow accepted by Prasidra how essential it is to protect the cows. Because he was always standing with the sword to protect the cows, he has no dynasty. And now Prabhupada is saying that we should understand that how important it is to protect the cows. One man, one goat. The son of the king, one prince, one Rajkumar, one prince has given his own life only for protection of cow. So some sons of a Kshatriya would take this war to protect the cows from ferocious animals, even at night. What then is to be said of sending cows to slaughterhouse? The Kshatriya's son sometime will take such a vow that they will protect the cows whole night, whole day, every time. So Prabhupada is saying that there is no point of sending cows to the slaughterhouse. Okay, cows are supposed to be protected. This is the most sinful activity in human society, to send cows in slaughterhouse. Okay, so this is wherever cow is being killed, that place will never flourish. Only the bad activities will happen there. Okay. So Khadgapane means he would stay awake all night with a sword in his hand. Yatata means with attention. Okay. Ekda pravishat goshtam sardulo nishi varshati shayana gava utthaya bhitasta babrumur vrije. Ekda, once upon a time, pravishat entered goshtam, the land of the cowshed, sardula, a tiger, Nishi at night Varshati while it was raining. Shayana lying down, Gava, Kau, Uthaya getting up, Bhita fearing, Taha all of them. Babhramu scattered here and there, Vrije in the land surrounding the cowshed. Once at night while it was raining, a tiger entered the land of the cowshed. Upon seeing the tiger, all the cows who were lying down got up in fear and scattered here and there on the land. So there was a cow shed, one goshala. In that goshala, this tiger entered. And Prasidra, he was there to protect the cows with a sword. Okay, but as soon as this tiger entered, all the cows started running here there. It was a big disturbance inside the goshala. Ekam jagrah balavan sa chukrush bhayotura tasyastu kranditam shrutva prasadro anusaraha khadgam adaya tarsa pralinodu ganeri nishi ajannam achinnod vabhro shira shardula sankal shankaya. Ekam, one of the cow jagras is balavan, the stronger tiger. Saw that cow chukrosha began to cry bhava akura in distress and fear. Tasya fartu but kranditam, the screaming shrutva hearing. Prasadra anusaraha followed khadgam swad adaya taking tarasa very hastily. Pralin udugane, when the stars were covered by cloud, nishi at night, ajanan, without knowledge. Achinot cut off babhro of the cow, shira the head, sardula sangaya, mistaking it for the head of the tiger. So there is a little problem happened here. What is that? When the very strong tiger seized a cow, the cow screamed in distress and fear. And Prasadra, hearing the screaming, immediately followed the sound. It was night. There was no light only. It was darkness. So when this king caught the one cow, cow was screaming. So he, Prasadra, followed the sound of the cow. He took up his sword, but because the stars were covered by clouds, he mistook the cow for the tiger and mistakenly cut off the cow's head with great force. So actually he wanted to kill the tiger, but mistakenly what happened that the cow was killed. That was the problem. Okay. Because there was no light. Anyway, it's night. So in night, sometime there is some light from stars or moon. So everything was covered because of cloud. And he mistook a cow for the tiger. So the cow was actually killed. But there was little this thing happened. What is that? Yeah. Vyagro api vrikin shravano nistrina shagrahatastataha nishchakram vrisham bhito raktam pati samskursujan. Vyagra, the tiger, api also vrikin shravanaha, its ear being cut off, nistrim agrahataha, because of being cut by the tip of the sword, tataha, thereafter nishchakrama fled from that place. Brisham, very much Gita, being afraid, raktam, blood, pati on the road, samsturusrajan, discharge. Because the tiger's ear had been cut by the edge of the sword, the tiger was very afraid and it fled from the place while bleeding on the street. What happened? When he killed the tiger, actually the cow was killed. But the sword also touched the ear of the tiger. So ear is cut and then the blood was flowing, and tiger, because the ear was cut, tiger also ran away. Manyamano hatam vyagram prasadra paravīraha atrakshitsva hatam babruhum vyastu vashutayam nishi dukhitaha. Manyamana, thinking that Hatamba has been killed, Vyagram, the tiger, Prasadra, Manusa and Prasadra, Paraviraha, although quite able to publish the enemy, Adrakshit, Swahatam had been killed by him, Babroom, the cow, Vishutayam Nishi. When the night had passed in the morning, Dukita became very much unhappy. Now in the night, anyway, whatever happened is happened. But in the morning, when Prasadra was quite able to subdue his enemy, saw that he had killed the cow, although at night he thought he had killed the tiger. Whole night he was thinking he has killed the tiger, but then morning came, he saw actually it is the cow which was killed. So he was very dukkita, he was very unhappy. तम सशाप कुलाचार्य कृतागसम अकामतः न क्षेत्र बंधु शूद्रस्तम कर्मणा भविता मुना तम हिम प्रसिद्र शशाप कर्ष कुल आचार्य द फैमिली प्रीज वशिष्ठ कृत आगसम बिकॉज ऑफ कमिटिंग द ग्रेट सिन ऑफ किलिंग अ काउ अकामता ऑल्दो ही हैड नॉट वांट ऑल्दो ही डिड नॉट वांट टू डू इट नॉ नॉट क्षेत्र बंधु द फैमिली मेंबर ऑफ छत्र बंधु द फैमिली मेंबर ऑफ क्षत्रिय शूद्र त्वम यू हैड बिहेव्ड लाइक अ शूद्र कर्मणा देयरफॉर बाय योर फ्रूड एक्टिविटी कविता यू शैल बिकम अ शूद्र अमुना बिकॉज ऑफ किलिंग द काउ दिस इज लिटिल difficult situation for Prasidra because he did not kill purposefully. So although Prasidra had committed the sin unknowingly, his family priest Vasishtha cursed him saying, in your next life you shall not be able to become a Kshatriya. Instead, you shall take birth as a Shudra because of killing the cow. Because you have done the activity of Shudra, you go and become Shudra. You will not become a Kshatriya in your next life. So it appears that Vasishtha was not free from Tamoguna. Prabhupada is writing in purport that it appears that Vasishtha was not free from Tamoguna, the mode of ignorance. As the family priest or spiritual master of Prasidra, Vasishtha should have taken Prasidra's offense very lightly. But instead, Vasishtha cursed him to become a Shudra. It is a duty of a family priest not to curse a disciple but to give him relief through the performance of some sort of attainment. Okay, so what Vasishtha should have done is, should have recommended some atonement. Okay, but he cursed him to become a Shudra. Vasishtha, however, did just the opposite. Therefore, Śrīla Viṣṇu Jagadīśa Thakura says that he was Durmati. In other words, his intelligence was not very good. Who's Vasishtha? Okay. So here the guru cursed him though he killed the cow unintentionally, akamataha, because it was not the intention of Maharaja Prasidra that he wanted to kill cow. Actually, he wanted to protect the cow, but somehow it happened, mistakenly it happened. So unintentionally he killed a cow, but guru cursed him. So he did not give instruction on atonement, but out of anger cursed him because his intelligence had disappeared. Out of anger, Guru cursed him. Okay, he should have given some process of atonement. That is because the action of family priests are subject to great ignorance. So that was the point. That's why Vishnu Chakravarti is saying that it was out of ignorance. What? The duty of Guru versus now. Okay, so those in the sixth canto this verse comes that those who are detached maintain themselves honestly by collecting grains left in the harvested field or left on the grain market floor. O rulers, how can I take up the condemned profession of a priest which gives joy only to the foolish? This is verse spoken by Vishrupa. Akinchananam hidhanam shilochanam tene nirvartita sadhu sakriyaha katam vigrahayam nukaromi adishvara kaurosadhasam hrishyatiyen durmatihi. Vasishtha cursed him saying that he could not even being a fallen Kshatriya but only a Shudra. So that was not very good idea to curse him, Prasidra. Why? Because he did not do this act as intentionally. It just happened. Evam sapta sattu guruna pratyagrahanat kritanjalihi adharayat vratam vira urdhvareta munipriyam. Evam in this way, Shapta, having been cursed too, but Guruna by his spiritual master Pratyagrahanat, he, Prasidra, accepted Krita Anjali with folded hands. Adarya took up, assumed Vrtam, the Brahmacharya Vrta, Vira, that hero, Urdureta, having controlled his senses, Muni Priyam, which is approved by the great sages. When the hero Prasidra was thus cursed by his spiritual master, he accepted the curse with folded hands. Then, Having controlled his senses, he took the vow of Brahmacharya, which is approved by all great sages. So, the Prasiddha with folded hands, he accepted the curse as mercy. He had devotion to Guru. He did not say, why did uselessly you curse me without reflecting first? First is to check what is the matter here, but you just simply cursing me. He did not say like that. Okay, he just accepted, oh, Guru is giving curse, it's also mercy of Guru. He accepted. Though cursed by his Guru, remaining faithful to Guru, he attained. Though cursed by his Guru, but still he was faithful to his Guru, he attained liberation without obstacle. That is the lesson of this story. Muni Priyam means a vow of service. So, even though Prasiddha was cursed, but he said, okay, this is also my Guru's mercy. Because he accepted that as the mercy of Guru, that's why he was also liberated without any obstacle. Okay. So sometimes it's very difficult because when we have not done a mistake, somebody scolds us, very difficult. Okay. So when Guru says something, so we have to accept like that. And sometimes it may be wrong, like here, but he accepted, and the result was as he was free from all the obstacles in the bhakti. Vasudeve Bhagavati Sarvatmani Pare Amale Ekantitvam Gato Bhaktya Sarvabhuta Suhrut Sama Vimukta Sangha Santatma Samyaktaksho Aparigradha Yadaritcha Yopapannena Kalpayan Virtim Atmanaha Atmani Atmanam Adhaya Jnana Triptaha Samadita Vichcharamahim Etam जडांध बोधि राकृति ही बोधि राकृति ही वासुदेवे अंटू द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड एंड भगवती अंटू द लॉर्ड सर्व आत्मनी अंटू द सुपर सोल परे अंटू द ट्रांसेंडेंट अमले अंटू द सुप्रीम पर्सन हु इज विदाउट नेटेड कंटेमिनेशन एकांतिवम रेंडरिंग टू संसार विदाउट डिस्ट डाइवर्जन Gata being situated in that position, Bhaktya because of pure devotion, Sarva Bhuta Suhrut Sama because of being a devotee, friendly and equal to everyone, Vimukta Sangha without material contamination, Shanta Atma, a peaceful attitude, Samhita, self control, Aksha, the version of whom, Aparigraha without accepting any charity from anyone else, Yad Richaya by the grace of the Lord, Upanena by whatever was available for bodily necessities, Kalpen in this way. Kalpyan in this way, arranging vrittim the necessities of the body, Atmana for the benefit of the soul, Atmani within the mind, Atmana the Supreme Soul, the personality of Godhead, Adhaya keeping always Jnana Tripta, fully satisfied in his transcendental knowledge. Samahitaha, always a trans virachara, travel all over Mahim, the earth, Etam, this Jada, dumb, Andha, blind, Badhira, deep, Akriti, appearing as it. Thereafter, Prasiddha got this curse. He accepted the curse as the mercy of his Guru. So thereafter, Prasiddha gained relief from all responsibilities, became peaceful in mind, and established control over all his senses. Being unaffected by material conditions, being pleased with whatever was available by the grace of the Lord to maintain body and soul together, and being equal toward everyone, he gave full attention to the Supreme Personality of Godhead Vasudeva, who is the transcendental super soul free from the material contamination. So here many qualities are mentioned, okay, about Prasiddha. Being unaffected by material condition, being pleased with whatever is available by the grace of the Lord to maintain body and soul together. Okay, so being unaffected. Whatever material condition comes, he was unaffected. Whatever by the mercy of Krishna he receives, just to maintain the body and soul together, he was happy. And being equal toward everyone. This is very important, being equal. This is the quality of devotee. Sama sarveshu bhuteshu pandita samdarsana. Like that many places, Krishna says that one should be equal toward everyone. He gave full attention to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudeva, who is the transcendental super soul, free from material contamination. So like that, Prasiddha was having many wonderful qualities, and that is why he was able to give up all these material things, and he fully focusing on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudeva. Okay. So, Prasiddha, and then in this way he became free from material contamination. And in this way Prasiddha, fully satisfied in pure knowledge, always keeping his mind on the Supreme Personality of Godhead, achieved pure devotional service to the Lord and began travelling all over the world without affection for material activities, as if he were deaf, dumb and blind. He fixed his mind Atmananam. He fixed his mind on the Lord Atmani. He was satisfied with knowledge and did not engage in the knowledge anymore, but was not fully satisfied with bhakti, wanting more and more. Okay, that was the point of Prasiddha. He was satisfied with knowledge, he was satisfied with the worldly thing, but he was not satisfied with bhakti. He wanted to do more and more bhakti. So, evam vritto vanam gatva drishtva davagnim uttitam ten upayukta karano brahma prapya paramuni. Evam vritta, being situated in such an order of life, vanam, or to the forest, gatva, after going, drishtva, when he saw, Dava Agnim, a forest fire, Uttitam, existing there, Tena, by that fire, Upayukta Karana, engaging all the senses of the body by burning, Brahma transcendence, Prapa, he achieved Param, the ultimate goal, Muni, as a great saintly person. So with this attitude, Prasiddha became a great saint, and when he entered the forest and saw a blazing forest fire, he took his opportunity to burn his body in the fire. Thus he achieved the transcendental spiritual world. Now, the Lord says in Bhagavad Gita 4.9, Janma karma chame divyam yo me veti tatvadha tekva deham punirjanma neti mamiti. So Arjuna, one who knows the transcendental nature of my appearance and activities, does not upon leaving the body take his birth again in this material world, but attains my spiritual abode, my eternal abode, O Arjuna. So Prasiddha, because of his karma, he was cursed to, this very important point, that he was cursed to take his next birth as a Sudra. But because he took to saintly life, specifically concentrating his mind always upon the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he became a pure devotee. Immediately after giving up his body in the fire, he reached the spiritual body as mentioned in Bhagavad Gita Mam Eti. Okay. As a result of his devotional situation, devotional service performed by thinking of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is so powerful that although Prasiddha was cursed, he avoided the terrible consequences of becoming a Sudra and instead returned home back to Godhead. This is a very important point here, that devotional service performed by thinking of the Supreme and Personality of Godhead is so powerful that although Prasiddha was cursed, he avoided the terrible consequences of becoming a Sudra and instead returned home back to Godhead. Okay? So this is why bhakti is very powerful process, and if somebody is on bhakti yoga, he should not, there is no need of taking help from any other or support from any other. Bhakti itself is very powerful. Okay, so even though he was cursed to become a Sudra, but he did not become, he went home back to Godhead. As stated in Brahma Samhita 551, Yastuva Indra Gopam Atavendram Ahoswa Karma Bandha Nurupa Phala Bhajanam Atanuti Karmani Nidrahati Kintucha Bhakti Bhajam Govindam Adi Purusham Tamham Bhajami. Those who engage in devotional service are unaffected by the results of the material activities. Whatever material activities give result, they are not unaffected. Otherwise, everyone from the smallest microbe up to the king of heaven, Indra, is subject to the laws of karma, even Indra. A pure devotee being always engaged in the service of the Lord is except from these laws. Okay. So, this is the point, that even if somebody does bhakti, even if some situations are there, some obstacles are there, but if a person is very fixed in bhakti, he can overcome all the obstacles. Okay. And the people who are engaged in bhakti of Krishna, they are unaffected by the all these result of material activities, because in bhakta will never do for anything for the material benefit. Okay. So that's why those who engage in devotion service are unaffected by the result of their material activities. Whatever comes, comes by Krishna's mercy. So a pure devotee are being always engaged in the service of the Lord is exempt from these laws. Okay. So Shuddha Bhakta, who is engaged in the service of the Lord, he is exempt from these laws. Okay. Okay, so they are no more entangled in the laws of karma. Okay, so like this, King Prasidra's story was there. He wanted to kill the tiger in order to protect the cow, but somehow it happened and he was cursed. But even after getting cursed, because he did so nice bhakti, so what happened? His bhakti was more powerful, so other thing got finished, or you can say controlled. So he did not, because the curse was to become Sudra in the next life, but he did not become Sudra because he was already liberated. Why? Because he did Mahayoga. Okay, so in this way you can understand that even that kind of such curse cannot do anything because he was doing the very nice bhakti. Okay, so in this way, this 14th shloka of this chapter 2 is over here. And now, this was first was the story of Sudyumna, now story of Prasidra. Now, the further dynasty of Manu will come. Okay. Hare Krishna, thank you so much, Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Gantrashman Bhagavatam ki jai. Anand Koti Vaishnavindi ki jai.